Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to my channel for another Hot Toys Star Wars figure review. Now, today we're going to be looking at the Emperor, a figure that I've been waiting a very, very long time to pick up. Now, I was looking at the Sideshow version from way back in the day, and when Hot Toys finally announced they were doing their very own version of the Emperor, I was super excited. So as soon as this guy came up on Timcent's page on eBay, straight from Secret Base, I had to pick him up. I was thinking about going for the deluxe version, but for all my reasons why I didn't, check out the Mint in Sealbox podcast with Zachary from King Zachary V, the YouTube channel. I discussed with him basically why I didn't go for the deluxe version, and he told me why he did. But enough about that. What we're going to do is get the accessories out here and take a look at everything he comes with. Now, in terms of accessories, he doesn't come with a lot, but he does come with the essentials. Obviously, if you get the deluxe version, he comes with that enormous throne room chair, as well as the Return of the Jedi Luke lightsaber. But he does come with his glossy black cane, which I always have a damn hard time getting these figures to hold canes. I don't know why, but even the little Yoda that I have, I really struggle getting him to hold his cane. Now, he also does come with a slew of hands, or when I say slew, he comes with four, so not too many. He comes with these sort of really wrinkled up and very well painted hands. You can see that he's got the veins in there and the dark sort of really crusty looking nails. It looks really gross, and I think that's exactly how the Emperor should look. He's a creepy old dude after all. He also does come with these lightning effects, and they are really nice. They're translucent and they sort of turn into this purpley color towards the end. I think in the film they were a little bit more blue, but correct me if I'm wrong. And they do attach to the hands. They are sort of connected to the corresponding hands, and you sort of slot them in just like so, and they loop around the fingers, as you can see, and it looks pretty good. You can sort of push it down a little bit further, and it's really sort of your choice on how you display these, but then it looks like the lightning is shooting out of his hands, which is a really, really nice effect. He does also come out with a more splayed out version of the lightning as well, really good to pose alongside the Luke or even the Darth Vader. Now, he does come with the usual Star Wars display base with the sticker sort of that you can put on top. I like to just apply the post directly onto that, and then you don't have to worry about sticking it down, and the friction usually sort of holds it in place nice enough, and it just sits there on your display looking really awesome. And it does sort of have this glossy finish on it, much like the Death Star floor. It looks really awesome. And they've also used the silver nameplate. I've mentioned a few of my videos now that they've stopped doing the silver nameplate on these newer figures. It looks like these Star Wars figures are going to carry on the silver nameplate. So anyway, enough about the base and the accessories. What we're going to do now is get the figure himself out here and take a look at the head sculpt. Now, as I said in the unboxing, the head sculpt is absolutely terrific, and they've also done a really good job with the robes, and I'm mentioning that because the hood sits on the head sculpt very, very nicely, and this is one thing that I was really concerned about, because even with the Anakin and the Luke Skywalker, I did have a real tough time getting the robe to sit properly, but this one is not a problem at all, just because of that wire around the hood, and you can see the hair is sculpted nicely as well. It looks really, really creepy. And just like the Emperor should, they've done a terrific job. And it, as I said, it just sits so nicely on the head sculpt, and it really does look like him from the film, especially from that angle. You get the really nice silhouette. Now, as for the robes themselves, he comes with this sort of black piece. I'm not exactly sure what that is. Someone in the comments, I'm sure, can let me know. And the fabric of the robes is really nice. It's got this canvasy sort of material to it. It's not waxy at all, which I thought it was going to be, but it does look the part, as in it looks like the robe from the film. Now, the arms themselves do have the wired sleeves, and you can see that the sort of gross skin texture carries on throughout the rest of the body. So it looks like at least the arms of the body are still that same sort of look. Now, he does have this bathrobe sort of thing on the underside with the tied up section there, and it looks like it's some sort of knot, some sort of bow there, and it looks really good. You're probably not going to ever see that. You're probably just going to have the outer robes closed over the figure there and him doing his thing. And it does look really good just posed with the outer robes on. Now, they are sort of a bit of a dust magnet, being black fabric, and any sort of little fuzzy piece of hair or something will just stick to it, and you will have to probably lint roller it here and there, but it does look the part. Now, the reason, or one of the reasons why I didn't get the throne, was just because it's going to be so undynamic having him posed on that chair 24/7, and if I didn't make use of the chair, I would feel incredibly bad, so that's why I went for this version, so I can have him displayed a little bit more dynamically with Vader or Luke when that Return of the Jedi Vader eventually does come out. Now, let's look at the hood from the back, and it looks like it's draping really nicely and it's sitting there. Maybe they've, they've stitched it down. You can see there the little stitch point where they've stitched it down to give it that real sort of, that heavy sort of look towards the back. As for the lower part of the robes and the boots, they are pretty well done. done. These are sort of a leathery type boot, although it does feel a little bit softer than something like we got with the Royal Guard or even some of the other Star Wars figures, but they always do these sort of fabric boots with the Star Wars figures. Now, he does have these black pants underneath his bathrobe, and I'm so sorry for anyone who's getting offended for me calling it a bathrobe, but that's exactly what it does look like. It is a nice gray color. I'm not sure if I mentioned that earlier, but it does all work together very nicely, and he definitely does look the part. There's little black fuzzles here and there from the outfit, but you do have to keep it clean with the lint brush, as I said, and just make sure that there aren't little sort of pieces landing on it all the time. But it does definitely look really, really good. Now, just before we do a size comparison, I thought I'd quickly show you that the robe is also wide at the bottom for anyone wondering, so you can get a little bit more of a dynamic pose if you really want to do that with the Emperor. Now, as for a quick size comparison, I will do a bit of a comparison video, not with other Emperor figures, obviously, because I don't have any, but with the Royal Guard, Darth Vader, Luke Skywalker, to give you a bit of a size comparison on how they all scale together, just because I've gotten into the sort of groove of doing the three videos when the figures release. So expect a video with those three figures all together, but this is just a quick one to see how the Royal Guard scales with the Emperor, because I know a lot of people are going to be buying these Royal Guards now that the Emperor's out to have them all displayed together. Now, I'm very well aware of the fact that a lot of reviewers are going to say that this Emperor is an absolute must-buy, and I just have to agree. He is an absolutely awesome piece. He comes with everything that he really needs to. Obviously, if you get the deluxe version, you'll be spoiled for choice with the chair and the extra lightsaber and everything. Everything you'd expect to come with the Emperor. But I think this standard version more than makes up for the old sideshow version with the crummy body, and just, it was a really lackluster sort of figure. It was great for its time, but now it hasn't aged very well. This version is definitely the one to have, especially if you're a Star Wars fan. And I know there are a ton of people who either like Return of the Jedi or Revenge of the Sith. This can be an Emperor from either of those two films. I think the robe is done really, really nicely. The head sculpt is absolutely fantastic. You know, if you do want to go for a custom robe, I'm sure there's going to be some from Unreal Customs or a few other different places, so you'll be able to check them out, I'm sure, and find some robes. But in the meantime, this is definitely going to do the trick. Now, that's about it for this video, guys. Check out the Mint and Seal Boxed Figure Podcast. It's on iTunes, Spotify, as well as a few other places. We've got a Facebook page, so definitely check us out on there. Check out my Instagram for photos of this figure, plus upcoming figure releases. Hella, I think, is going to be next week. I'll be picking her up pretty much day one, so you can expect videos of her on the channel. So that's about it, guys. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.